I'm gonna throw out two words that may soon be a part of your diet. Pond scum. Yes, I'm talking about that delicious looking film of green that coats small lakes, rivers, and fish tanks all over the world. Yum. Now there are innovators creating future food out of slimy algae in a tube. These microalgae, like all other plants, contribute to the air we breathe each day. But beyond that, the miracle of algae, as inventor Frederica Goldfoot puts it, is their ability to produce essential nutrients that animals and humans consume, like omega-3 fatty acids. Frederica's quest to harvest the benefits of algae and help save the Earth's fish supply in the process is what led her to create Simris, an algae farm that produces omega-3 supplements. Frederica spoke to me from southern Sweden. Hi, Frederica, and welcome to Innovation Nation.
Hi, Mo. I'm super happy to be on your show. Thanks for having me.
So how did you come up with the idea to grow algae, of all things?
I was doing my PhD in plant biotechnology, and I learned more and more about the vast opportunities with algae. So algae are tiny little microscopic plants, and you can do so many things with them. And I kind of fell in love with algae, and I fell in love with the idea of once having an algae farm of my own.
Frederica chose to focus on producing omega-3 supplements, the type contained in fish oil. Fish eat the algae that contain the nutrients.
We do need to obtain omega-3 fatty acids with our diets. Now, one way to do this is by eating a lot of fatty fish. Everybody knows that eating fatty fish is healthy. However, many people rely on fish oil supplements. Unfortunately, fish oil is one of the big economic drivers for overfishing in the oceans.
The team at Simris invented a system to mimic an ocean environment in a greenhouse. All right, walk me through the growing process.
You take a little starter culture, and then you start grow it in larger and larger volumes of seawater. In the beginning, you have them shaking in flasks in a so-called incubator. And once they have grown there, you will transfer them to larger vessels until you put them in production, essentially, in those large modules of long, long glass tubes, which we have in our farm and our greenhouses.
There, the algae are exposed to sunlight and are fed with carbon dioxide. Then the algae produce the omega-3s. At that point, the algae are harvested, freeze-dried, and ready for the oils to be extracted and bottled. It's a process Frederica hopes can bring better health not only to our bodies, but also to our planet. Well, thank you, Frederica, for bringing us your innovation, and best of luck.
Thank you, Mo.